Hello friends, now let's continue with our PGPP head. The remaining sections which were left will be taught today. Let's start with section 35 CCC. This section is related to agriculture. So first let's see how much deduction we'll get in this. Deduction at the rate of 150%. For what purpose? Let's see the purpose. 150% of expenditure incurred by the SSE. Wait, let me zoom. Incurred by the SSE for notified agriculture extension / expansion project in accordance to the given guidelines. Guidelines are given by the act of that guidelines. These are all not important. Just remember agriculture extension / expansion project. If the SSE have made expense relating to agriculture extension expansion, then such expenses will not allowed 100% but 150%. What does 100% mean? First understand that the entire expenses will be allowed, but 50% more expenses will be allowed. If you have spent 100 rupees for agriculture expansion, 100 rupees will be allowed plus 50% is equal to 150 rupees will be allowed as deduction from the gross profit. Okay, I'm telling gross profit because I'm keeping it very simple right now. When the sum will come in a inverse manner, when the net profit will be given and all the expenses will be given, from that we have to add and subtract. That I'll be teaching you later, don't worry about it. First understand that GP, from the GP not 100% expenses will be allowed, but 150% of expenses of agriculture extension expansion project will be allowed. So are you getting this? Section 35 CCC, just remember, I'm not marking here a star, so remember it might come for theory. If it comes in the question, if it is given in the question in the calculation of computation of the total income, in that sum you have to keep an eye while seeing if they have given in the question agriculture extension or expansion project. If such expenses are there in the P&L account, then 100% expenses, that is rupees 100, will be allowed plus 50% more will be allowed on that expenses. Are you getting it? That's why it is given 150% deduction of the expenses. See, 150% means if 100 rupees you have if you have spent, then 150% is equal to 150% is equal to 150. You getting it? I hope section 35 CC is cleared. Now let's move on to section 35 CCD. See, here I can't make anything simple. You have to remember few sections, because in my previous lectures I made few sections so that it might register in your brain and you remember it, what it is and what how to remember it. But now you have few, hardly 10 to 15 sections will be there. You have to memorize it. There is no other option. I'm sorry for that. Section 35, expenditure by company for NSD. What is NSD? Notify Skill Development Project, NSDP. It is also there in our service tax. When I'll be teaching you service tax, that time I'll go into detail about NSDP. Now just remember this much. Deduction, first see how much deduction will be allowed. Deduction at the rate of 150, at the rate of 150%. Let's write the theory part. Expenditure incurred by the SSE, that is only company related to नेशनल NSDP मीन्स नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट प्रोजेक्ट. Then only 150%. Then only 150% deduction will be allowed. I hope now 150% of deduction is clear to you all. NSDP. Please don't copy right now. I'll give you time to copy. So now let me explain little bit. It is self-explanatory, but still I want to explain little bit. Expenditure by company for National Skill Development Program. What does National Skill Development Project means? If you have started a personality development classes or specified development program given by the guidelines of the act, then such expenses incurred by the company will not be allowed at 100% but at the rate of 150%. I hope this much is clear. You have to remember the section, that is mandatory, but besides section you should know the matter inside, what the matter says inside the section. So I hope now it is clear to you all. Now let's move on to section 35D. Here you might get a few help. Section 35D is related to preliminary expenses. It is related to what? Preliminary expenses. Which preliminary expenses? So, see. I have written the code behind. Dope Smurf Square. F square. I hope this is visible to you all. See which all expenses are allowed. Drafting of MOA. D stands for drafting of MOA. I hope MOA is Memorandum of Association. You know this much. You have at least studied Companies Act. What is MOA? Memorandum of Association. O stands for other approved expenses. Third, P stands for project report. Fourth stands for engineering services. Fifth, S stands for shares and debentures. Issue expenses. 6 stands for market survey. U stands for underwriting commission. R stands for registration fees. F stands for feasibility report. 10 stands for foreign collaboration expenses. So this many expenses will be allowed. There is a condition, additional condition for this that I am writing over here. Deduction will be allowed in this manner. See, deduction let's draw a chart. In case of Indian company, other than Indian company, that is Indian resident, so how the expenses will be allowed? See, firstly, 1/5 of the entire expenses will be allowed in the previous year. That I'll be writing, the statement will be written down. I'm just telling you in advance how to calculate फर्स्ट ए एक्चुअल एक्सपेंसेस डन,